Hello students, in this episode we will be discussing about leadership traits. I hope you understand what is trait. Trait means characteristics or the qualities of a leader. And in this episode we will be discussing what are the qualities which makes a leader from or differentiate a leader from a non-leader. By the way, there are many characteristics which differentiate between leadership and non-leaders. However, we cannot give justice discussing all the qualities of leaders. We will be discussing only few important qualities of leaders. And this is an area of research which continued since 20th century, beginning of 20th century. You must be aware of that when scientific study of leadership started, this came into existence that the leaders, the major leaders, important leaders, what are the characteristics lies with them which made them leader. Now, the interest generated in the beginning of 20th century still continuing. So, you must be thinking that if it is still continuing, why so? Because the researchers are still trying to find out what are these major characteristics which differentiate a leader from a non-leader. The big leaders and their characteristics has been analyzed, and it has been found out one of the important characteristics is intelligence. A leader needs to have higher intelligence. He need to grasp the concepts, he need to grasp the happenings, he need to understand or ability to understand what is going on in this world, so that he can visualize, he can create a vision, he can lead the people, he can transform. Now, since intelligence is one of the major area, again, intelligence is differentiated: general intelligence, fluid intelligence, social intelligence, emotional intelligence. There are varieties, but our focus now is on general intelligence. It is the ability to learn a new thing. So, one leader should have the ability to learn new things, to grasp over new things. And this trait is very important for a leader. Next is emotional stability. A leader should have emotional stability. He should not get stressed, confused, because stress leads to confusion. And higher level of stress leads to burnout stage. In a burnout stage, a person collapses. So, you can imagine if stress level is high and the person doesn't have emotional stability, then it may lead to burnout stage. So, emotional stability is very important, not only controlling his emotion, but also controlling other emotion, which is so emotional intelligence. Now, researchers also found out that in a stressful condition, one experienced leader will be more effective rather than a knowledgeable leader. The second important point we will be discussing is dominance. A leader, another important characteristics found out by the researcher, that a leader needs to play a dominant role. Why such dominant role? Because whenever there is a conflict among the groups or between few followers, a leader has to come forward, dominate, and carry forward the people towards the achieving the goal. Next important characteristics will be discussed with regard to enthusiasm. A leader should have enthusiasm to do something, and this is one inner motivational characteristics. He need to focus on the activities, and he should be self-motivated, self-driven, and zeal to achieve something. This is other way, you can say achievement orientation. And this is very important feature a leader must have. Next important characteristics is conscientiousness. What is conscientiousness? It is the justified way to do something. One should be wise enough to follow the ethical principles and carry out the functions in a justified way. Otherwise, there will be problem. In a short run, a leader can manipulate, do the things, but a long run, definitely he cannot be successful. Next important characteristics we will be discussing about boldness. A leader needs to be very bold. Whichever steps in his analysis he finds out is the appropriate for the people, he should be bold enough or assertive. And please mind it, assertive, aggressiveness are two different things. You should be assertive, not aggressive. One leader has to put forward the points without aggression. Next important characteristics, tough minded. A leader in different situation should not break. He should have a tough mind to analyze the things, carry out, find out the solution from different sources and evaluation of the alternatives to come out with the right solution. And he has to pursue that. Next important characteristics we will be discussing is about self-awareness, which is part of social intelligence. One leader needs to know his strength and weaknesses. Both strength, you must have heard about SWOT analysis, strength, weaknesses, opportunity, threat. Strength and weaknesses lies within the person. Opportunity and threat lies outside. Here we will be focusing upon the internal qualities, that is the strength and weaknesses. One leader has to analyze his own characteristics before he leads the followers. His own strength, weaknesses, he needs to find out. That will give him a sense of his characteristics, which can influence and which are the things he has to maneuver. Next important characteristics will be high energy. One leader not only have these personality qualities but also physical qualities. Physical qualities, high energy. Many a times while pursuing a task, we felt restlessness, we felt drained out because the energy level is not so high. The leader has to have high energy level to put forward his goals and lead the followers. Next important characteristics or the trait of leadership could be intuitiveness. Many researchers have no unanimity with regard to these things. Intuitiveness may not be very scientific. While forecasting, we follow scientific methods. But intuitiveness is perhaps one of the inborn quality of a person which differentiate a person as a leader from others. He should able to forecast what will be happening, and it is the gut within the person which tells him what will be the scenario, and he goes for proactive measures rather than reactive measures. So to become very proactive, intuitiveness is one of the important characteristics. Next important characteristics we'll be discussing about the maturity. You must have heard about childishness, which is opposite to maturity. I am not talking about physical maturity, rather we are talking here about psychological maturity. The willingness, the intelligence, the skill, knowledge brings maturity in a person. And unless a leader is very mature, he cannot handle his subordinates or the followers. Another important characteristics nowadays coming forward is team or team orientation. A leader has to go for team orientation. He has to take others along with him. What are the characteristics of a team which differentiates it from group? Group, a combination of people may be having different objective and complementary skill set may be absent. But in a team, you can think of Indian cricket team. Complementary set of skills is there. Winning is the goal and everybody synergetically works towards it. So leader has to bring that synergy in the group. Next important characteristics is empathy. What is empathy? What is sympathy? Sympathy is to just to show that you are concerned. Empathy, when you put the shoe of other person and feel where it pinches. That means you have to internalize the situation of the followers or the problem of the followers. Now, another important characteristics is the charisma, that is the personality. Some people like Nehru, we consider them as charismatic people. They have inbuilt personality in them which attracts people. And many, I am sure, you might have heard about many of the spiritual leaders or the Baba cults. They have perhaps this charisma which attracts people towards them. And last but not least, we will be discussing about the self-monitoring, self-motivation and self-drive. Self-monitoring and self-motivation is much required because a leader in isolation has to be motivated by himself. Many a times when he brings changes, people may not accept that. It's not that they are not accepting because they are against it. Maybe they need more learning in that field. So with this, I hope you understood some of the important characteristics or traits of leadership. Thank you.